name is Steve Stevens, the best sports consultant money can buy. I make more money betting sports than anybody in the world. I'm the one that tells you who to bet. I'm not a bookie. I'm the Bookie Killer.
If money talks, then I got a lot to say. I'm on the grind trying to make $100,000 a day. The game that I pick, believe me, it's a winner. What I know could get you rich, cause all I pick is winners. Welcome to Las Vegas. Money talks, money talks. Welcome to Las Vegas.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to the VIP Sports Podcast. I'm Steve Stevens, a.k.a. the Bookie Killer, sitting here with my co-host, Big Skipper. Good afternoon to you, Skipper.
Good afternoon, Mr. Stevens. Fun, sun, and beautiful women.
That it is. Even though the weather's still hot, my games are hotter. Coming off a 12-game winning streak, winning 12 out of the last 15 games, all of my personal player level people that have my personal play service, congratulations. To my other guys that have different levels of service, do whatever it takes to get those personal plays and get you on the winning side. Fair enough?
Fair enough.
Buddy, kicking ass and taking names. Another day, another dollar. Couldn't be more excited. We have a fun-filled show for these people today. We got a lot of stuff to go over. But before we get into it, this is podcast number 86.
Yes, sir.
86. You have anything that 86 comes to mind?
The first 86 that comes to my mind, that's the year I graduated high school.
Steve. Holy shit. 1986, baby.
86 was a beautiful year.
So in that year, I'm thinking, you guys, what was cool? 68 Camaro,
yeah.
Marlboro Red cigarettes, rock and roll, a loud stereo, and the women had their feathered, pretty much a comb. And Ozzy Osbourne shirt with Levi's, huh?
I had a mullet.
Okay, yeah, definitely the mullet.
I had a mullet. I had a little gold chain. Every once in a while, a silver chain, but mainly a gold chain.
A little gold chain?
Yeah, one of the last times I ever wore jewelry.
You had to have wore the Levi's with a cutoff Ozzy shirt or some type of fucking shirt.
Well, I didn't have no cutoff shirts. But
well, you know, I rock did, and roll shirt, some type.
I had plenty of black concert T-shirts. Yes, I did. I had the
I fucking knew it.
I had the mullet. I had a 1977 Chevy Nova. My best friend had a Camaro. We did a lot of racing, a lot of street racing, picked up a lot of girls. And it was the year that I started dating my wife, as a matter of fact.
So 1986 was a pretty solid and memorable year for you. Graduated high school and met your best friend and the woman of your dreams. Congratulations.
I got to rescind that. We've been together since 85. I just made a big mistake.
Oh, did you? Well, you're in trouble. You'll have to get right home after work, make sure pick up some P.F. Chang's or something.
Well, that'll be the first time I went right home after work.
Oh. That's a fact. You do that, you pop the bottles. Oh, no, you'll get there.
Oh, boy.
But anyway, famous number 86, Skip. You should have known this right off the bat. Hines Ward.
Yes.
Hines Ward, Steelers all-time leader in receptions, being a guy from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, Philly to be exact. Eastside Philly, correct?
Yeah, listen, I wasn't a big Steelers fan. I'm on the other side of the state.
Yeah, I know, you're Eagles. You've made it clear.
Yeah, I'm totally Philadelphia. I'm on the other side of the state. However, I've been to Three River Stadium. I've been to a couple Steelers games. I actually broke my ankle in the parking lot at Three River Stadium.
Yeah, did you? How many beers were you on?
Quite a few beers. playing tackle football in the parking lot on the cement. They gave the ball to the big skipper on the one-yard line. And I broke my ankle going in. Yeah.
On the 1 yard line.
Yes.
You broke your ankle going in.
Yes, I did.
You gave it all you got. Did you score, Skip?
If I recall, I don't remember if I
Skip,
scored.
Skip,
I
was Skip, in a lot beyond,
of pain. Yeah, I scored. I was in a lot of fucking pain.
I want you guys to comment right now. Do you think he fucking scored? I say he broke his ankle as soon as he got the ball and did not get over. We'll have to find some tape of that fucking...
Tuck it right here, man.
So was this like...
It was like fucking remember Refrigerator Perry?
Yeah, I was thinking of the exact same thing.
Yeah, give me the fucking ball on the one, man. We're getting there.
They used that same Refrigerator Perry tactic later on and the NFL just didn't work.
I did break my ankle in three River Stadium parking lot playing tackle football.
All right, so where
on the cement. I mean, you got to be fucking drunk to be doing that.
Well, you do, and you know what? That's pretty much made you the guy you are today, which is not only one of the best salesmen in the world, but good friend of mine. I'll go to war for you anytime, pal.
Thank you. Vice versa, sir.
At the end of the day, like I said, we got an action-packed show. We're going to go over preseason. A lot of stipulations on preseason football. People are asking, is this the time to bet? Is this not the time to bet? We'll get into that. We're going to go over also Major League Baseball making more money and breaking records more than ever right now.
Baseball absolutely on fire.
What team is on fire? Who's breaking streaks? Who to get good money on? What games are traps? Et cetera, et cetera, et cetera.
Just continue to dominate the baseball board, Steve.
Absolutely. Before we get into the show, like I said, August 18th, 2016, baseball is in full effect right now. See, we're not to the point, ladies and gentlemen, where we're selling football and adding baseball in. We're still to the point where we're full out selling baseball and adding preseason to any high-level plays to help you make money, pretty much, huh?
Yep.
Skip, before we get into the show, like I said, we got an action-packed show. We're laser-focused on football right now. If we're smelling it, we're living it, we're feeling it, and we're, more importantly, suited up, fucking paint on our face, putting the pads on, ready to go to war for you guys. Guys that are looking to make money, guys that need a second investment. If you're just tuning into the VIP Sports Podcast, it's all about the legalization of sports, all about sports betting, and how to become a better sports bettor. I'm the number one documented individual in the world. Nobody deals with bigger sports bettors than me. Nobody bets more money than me. And nobody wins more than our organization, period. And like I said, that's all we're here to do is tell you guys how to be better sports bettors, give you the lingo, teach you money management and discipline, also by supporting the legalization of gambling and talking shit about every player, sport, Kardashian, or anything that's in entertainment news as well.
Amen, brother.
Before we get into the show, Skip, why don't you tell these people how they can get a hold of us if they're looking to sign up or they just want to start small or they want to bet $100,000 a game or they've never done it before or they've done it before on their own and they're not winning or they're doing it now and they're winning.
Right.
Why don't you tell them what they can do to get a hold of us?
If you're looking to beat your bookie, if you've never bet before or you're currently betting and you just want to add some bullets to your arsenal or add a tank to your forces, the easiest way to get a hold of us, Steve, is if they just pick up the phone and call us. 877-220-6540. That's 877-220-6540. Give us a call. If you're looking for a free pick, you want to test the waters, go to our website. It's VIPSportsLasVegas.com. We have all kinds of packages on there, different levels for every shape and size of a sports bettor, whether you're betting $100 a game or you're betting $50,000 a game. There's all kinds of packages on the website. You'll find that there as well.
But one thing we don't want you to do, if you're calling us with your last $200 and you're asking us to help you, don't call us at all. We don't accept guys that are betting with their last $200. Go buy yourself a sandwich and buy some food for the next 2 weeks. Right. We have a saying out here in Vegas. Broke men shouldn't gamble and jealous men shouldn't pimp holes. You'll never get money chasing shit down like that. If you can't afford to come aboard for $250, that's usually the smallest promotion that we're running.
Right.
$250 promotion for 7 days of service, no offense, you shouldn't be gambling. Mm-hmm. So if you're lower than that or you can't afford one of the $99 crazy specials that we're running, just don't even call.
Yeah.
Because, I mean, that's
no, no disrespect. It doesn't make you a bad guy.
It just means you're not ready to start betting sports.
Right.
And you call us to bet sports, not to talk about sports.
Right. We do sell a dream here because that's what we do. We make people's dreams come to reality.
But we're sports consultants. My job strictly and solely only is to make you money and investment by betting sports.
Right. But if you have $237 to your name and you got two kids and your wife is out of work taking care of the children and you just don't have any money.
I don't want it.
And you think that I can turn your $237 into $5,000 a week? It doesn't work that way. You got to have a little bit of bankroll. But at the same time, I mean, if you're working with $1,000 or $2,000 and you want to do this thing the right way, by all means, get a hold of us.
Skip, all I'm saying is you can be a guy in college. You can be a guy with a normal job. What I'm trying to say is, if the smallest player starting out is like a $100 player, that's the smallest level.
Right.
Our average player at VIP, we're blessed, is about an $800 player.
Right.
Your average
500 to 1,000 is the average bet.
Us, yeah, you know, and then we have probably 100 guys that bet 5,000 or more, which we're blessed. But if if you have $250 to sign up with us, or let's just say even a $99 package, mm-hmm. you have $99 to sign up with us and $300-$400 to put in a betting account, and you want to try it for fun and you're making a normal job, we can make you money too.
Right.
Just don't try to call us with the only $300 you have in your life
Correct.
And ask to give us $100 and help you turn your only $200 into something else, because all you're bringing is negativity. We want to help you. We want to get to the next level, but gambling's not for everybody. It's high risk, high reward. It's a game for big boys. Once again, it's not for everybody.
Right.
However, even the average Joe can make money. One thing that I want everyone to do is, you know, and even all my people out there in Armed Force Radio Network, we have hundreds of thousands of people. I'm actually a little upset with you guys. We have hundreds of thousands of people listening to the podcast, and none of them are subscribing to the podcast. I mean, I'm working my ass off to give you guys all the information. I'm giving you subliminal messages on how to make a ton of fucking money. I'm motivating you guys every single day, doing whatever it takes to teach you new sales techniques, let you read my mind, let you give it the blueprint to make millions of dollars. The least you could do is press the fucking subscribe button and subscribe to our podcast, because we're all organic. We don't market. We have tens of thousands of viewers strictly organic. We don't market it anywhere, and we want to stay that way. It's called natural. No bot views, no fake nothing, no marketing. Guys that strictly are coming across us organically. And that's how we're going to keep it, Skip.
All natural.
All natural. Just like the games. You know, we've got an organic game for you today. No additives, no preservatives, strictly natural. Shit, I'm going to have to put that on the game sheet.
No artificial colors, no
fucking odor selection. How about a fucking organic game? No additives, no preservatives, no bullshit.
No artificial colors, no artificial flavors.
No telephone tough guys, no guys claiming to be multi-met, you know. Mm-hmm.
Follow us on Twitter. Follow us on Facebook. We're on Instagram. VIP Sports LV. You can direct message us there if you got any questions.
Whether you watch our YouTube videos or what, put in your comments. We love everything you say. We love all the support that you guys have given us. We'll be doing shout outs next week. We'll give shout outs where shout outs are due to all of our people. We love you out there. But leave your comments in there. Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. We do all that for you guys to bring you the lives of a guy that bets big and live large. And that's pretty much what it is. Shout out to all the military heroes listening. To the VIP Sports Podcast. Check us out on Fridays at 11:30 a.m. Pacific and on Mondays at 6 a.m. and again at 6 p.m. Once again, thank you for keeping our country safe, but learn how to press the subscribe button when you go mm-hmm. to our podcast. I constantly say thanks for keeping us safe. You deserve more money. I'm fighting for you. Will you fight for me a little bit and press the subscribe button?
There you go.
Anyway, Skip, let's get right into a beautiful show today, huh?
Right on.
We got a lot to talk about, I tell you that. Why don't we just get into news on the legalization of sports betting as the NBA prepares for the United States sports betting expansion?
It appears that they are believing that sports betting is going to become legal real soon.
You think?
Yeah. The NBA is seriously involved in the legalization.
Well, I'll just give you an example. Sports data company, Sports Radar, is in the final stages of closing, listen to this, a $250 million six-year deal with the NBA. According to the report by Bloomberg, also involved is a deal with Second Spectrum, which already provides stuff like data, analytics, visualization, video solutions to about half the NBA's teams.
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, when you're giving out stats, I mean, the report quotes an anonymous source saying that the deal covers selling the official league data to betting houses, data analytics to teams, and development of basically a streaming product. Giving them all the information, the stats, streaming everything they have to basically make sports betting legal and for all the teams to have the stats and pretty much what it is, what we see here in a line in Vegas pretty much is what I'm getting out of it.
Well, when the league is preparing to do business with betting houses, that's when shit's getting serious.
When they're asking for analytics, they're asking yeah. for stats, they're asking for ERAs, mm-hmm. they're asking for records. It's no different than, you know, going to like scoresandodds.com. What they're saying is they're setting up data and analytics and scores and odds and against mm-hmm. the spreads and basically making lines just like Las Vegas, making a blueprint structure to actually make sports betting legal and all the teams know about it. And it's not going to be a secret. When gambling becomes legal, the team that plays that night is going to be knowing the spread's -5. They already know now, Skip. Mm-hmm.
Oh, absolutely they do.
But as you say, I mean, when they're getting this far with it and companies are putting in hundreds and hundreds of millions, we're just a year or two away or less of making it legal everywhere, brother.
The NBA has entered into a six-year, $250 million deal to provide statistics and information to betting houses.
Correct.
That's when you know sports betting is going to become legal in the very near future.
Not to mention the NBA's for it, the NFL's for it, Major League Baseball is for it. All the commissioners and all the right people are saying let's make it legal. However, right now it's still illegal. So once again, as we said before, you can't just come out and cheerlead for something that's illegal. You can make your stance and say I think it should be legal, mm-hmm. but you can't keep make it legal, holding up signs because you look stupid and you want to keep your job, whether you're a politician, a head coach, whoever, a spokesman, right. or whoever you are in the NBA league, commissioner, et cetera. The commissioners have said it over and over, make it legal. What do you want them to do? Come up with a protest? Mm-hmm. They don't want to get in too much heat. You know what I mean?
Well, the easiest thing to do is just get on a plane or get on your horse and giddy up and get on out here to Las Vegas.
That's a fucking fact. So NBA commissioner and everybody that wants to make it legal with the better betting structure, all you got to do is take the structure from Las Vegas, keep it exactly how we do it, open up your betting parlors, start out with limits at $1,000, make everything legal, and get to work. Because the biggest thing you're going to have to worry about is security because of how much motherfucking money you're going to bring in across the United States of America. The city and the state that's collecting those bets and those betting houses are going to get filthy rich.
Oh, absolutely.
I mean, let's be honest, Skip. I'm a bookie killer. I'm the best in the world. But out of a trillion-dollar industry, I'd probably say VIP is probably only responsible for $1 billion a year of that. I'm talking about touting-wise, $1 billion.
Yeah, very minute percentage tens of what's really going on. Yeah.
We'd have to say tens of millions of dollars that we're actually touting and getting our hands on. So to a world of legal, well, first of all, once it becomes legal, I'll be the biggest face in the world and I'll be just as big. But mm-hmm. When it becomes legal, I'll be this little to those books who don't know me.
Right.
But the people that don't know me aren't dealing with us. They lose. Sports books are built off losers, guys. The average guy, 9 out of 10 people that walk into a book on a consistent basis lose. They don't keep building casinos and bigger sports books because everybody's winning.
Absolutely.
That's why they kick guys like me out of the fucking casino and don't make me let bets. They let guys like make $500 bets, average Joes, guys that come in from Arkansas that are this, that, and the other, want to lay down $5,000-$10,000 because they know they're drunk and in town for the rodeo, or this guy that's in for the SEMA show, or mm-hmm. this guy that's in for the porn show. Guys like that is who they let bet. And then again, you have all the guys that think they know what they're doing, reading the newspapers and sitting in the sports books, which we call those degenerates. Those guys, they let bet all day long because they wouldn't know how to win with your fucking money.
Well, the sports books aren't open because the average person wins. That's for damn sure.
But we also know that the it's a little off scale. The sports books, we've already said it, the Super Bowl took in $300 million in total bets, but there was actually 4.2 billion bet illegally on the Super Bowl. Mm-hmm. So if it was all bet legally, look at the number difference. Tax that, pave the roads, take care of our schools, and leave us the fuck alone. Wake the fuck up.
Yeah, the amount of money being legally wagered on sports is so small compared to the actual amount that's being wagered. It's ridiculous.
Sorry to get into it, but that's what we were talking about. You know, when you talk about legalization of sports, that's why you and I do the show. Just like Donald Trump and politics, I can go all day about that, okay? So, you know, it's real simple. They got money for war, but they don't have money to feed the poor, but they don't want to make sports betting legal. A guaranteed thing that every politician and every motherfucking attorney and every hedge fund guy and every oil tycoon and everybody with money does anyway.
Absolutely they do.
When you're a little kid in elementary school, you're getting ready to run a race with your friend or something. So what's the first thing you say? Hey, man, I bet you can.
Yeah, I bet you I bet you pack a bubble gum, I can beat you.
Skip, that's instilled with us as Americans in the United States of America.
Well, period. Yeah, it makes everything interesting.
So make it fucking legal. It's just American as fucking baseball.
You got to put a little something on the line. You got to get some skin in the game.
So let's make sports betting legal. And like I said, we're close as hell to doing it. Let's get in right into a little baseball, which is right up your alley, Skip. Mm. Just to get into it, Major League Baseball has been phenomenal for us. I've been kicking ass and taking names. Have we taken a couple hard losses here and there? Absolutely. I'm not one of those guys that are going to sit on the fucking podcast and tell you I win every game, 15-0 out of my last 15 games. Yes, I'm on fire right now, but I do lose games. But as long as I win 3.5 games to every one I lose, I don't think anyone in the world has ever had a problem going 7-2.
I know, I don't.
14-4.
Absolutely.
28-8. I mean, that's the type of money that you can get rich off. It's the type of statistic, money management and discipline that you can get rich. That's why it's called the formula for success.
Yeah, well, when you got a run line and they leave the bases loaded 2 innings in a row and can't can't even hit a fly ball.
You took the words out of my
mouth. I mean, a sacrifice fly fucking changes those numbers to 17-1.
You got bases, correct. You got bases loaded in the eighth, well, you got second and third in the eighth inning, one out. Then they load the bases, you can't get it. Ninth inning, bases loaded, one out, you can't get a run in. Our team won 5-4, but we had the run line, tough loss. Yeah. But at the same time,
it happens.
Well, it does, but at the same time, we're not the type of guy to give a guy a Dodger game minus $1.90. You don't need us for that, guys. Let all those internet wanksters online that tells you how good they are, deal with them for that type of shit. And once again, guys, speaking of internet trolls, if you are listening to the VIP Sports Podcast, I want everyone to be alerted. Everybody trolls our comments. Everybody trolls our podcast. Everybody trolls everything I do. They make up fake viewers, and they bust your guys' balls. Then they ask you to sign up with them, or they act like they're me, or they're acting like they're VIP Sports. We don't solicit anybody that way through email, through YouTube, through our comments at all. Let's make that clear right away. So if you comment on the VIP Sports Podcast, make sure you don't fall in the trap of these fucking trolls or any of these guys calling you or talking shit. Somebody emails you or tries to get to you, just tell them to eat a good old-fashioned dick. Fair enough?
Eat a good old-fashioned dick.
Skip, a baseball, the more important thing that everyone wants to hear from your mouth as well as mine. I'll start you off. This is your segment. American League East, Toronto in first place. Baltimore and Boston just behind. Baltimore to have a couple games at home, which thank God, because that seems to me like the only place they can win.
Right.
Boston Red Sox is a team that you better look out for. You better watch out. You better not cry, because they will ruin your motherfucking Christmas. Boston Red Sox are a solid team.
They score runs.
And they can come bite you. That team has made us more money betting the over than any team this year. And ladies and gentlemen, we've told you several times, totals are we're making all the money. It's even money bet. Why would you bet $1.50 or try to take a shot at plus $1.70 when it's just too hard to lose? You got to pick and choose your bets. Play the sports book. Don't let the sports book play you. If there's only three games on the board, does that mean you got to make a bet, Skip?
No, it doesn't.
No, it means you chill the fuck out, take your girlfriend to eat, well, take your wife to eat, take your kids to eat, and have a family day. That's what you do.
The Toronto Blue Jays have overtaken the American League East. I want to pat myself on the back for this one. I believe Toronto Blue Jays are going to be there right at the end. I believe they're going to win the East. I believe they're going to be in the American League Championship Series. And I wouldn't be surprised when they make it to the World Series. They could possibly win it all. But right now, it looks like Toronto and the Dodgers to me, just for the record. But, yes, congratulations, Toronto. They've actually taken over. They're a game and a half up on the Red Sox. Baltimore, because they can't win on the road, they've slipped. They're down two games to Toronto. But this American League East is one hell of a... one hell of a division.
Now, let me ask you this, because I have a quick question here. Like, obviously, we love Canada. Canada's not part of the United States of America. Some people say if Toronto did go there, it would be a disgrace. America is baseball. Canada wins. We're from America. But at the same time, and like I've told people over and over, Major League Baseball is the one that put the fucking team in Canada. So, I mean, Skip, it's not necessarily the players' fault. If you won for Toronto, saying another country won, I mean, those are still American. I mean, isn't that a USA team? I mean, how do you explain that to these fucking people?
I don't, you know, that's...
Do you kind of understand what they're asking?
That's a crazy situation. I mean, they're...
Toronto wins, they're from Canada. However, Major League Baseball is the one that put them in Canada. Yeah. Why the fuck do we have a team in Canada?
Baseball, apple pie, Chevrolet, and Steve Stevens.
Yeah, and where does old Canada, where's that fit in?
I know, the only team left in Canada, and they could easily be in the World Series. They might win it all.
But they're the same players in Major League Baseball divided up as any other team.
Yeah.
It's not a bunch of Canadians.
Just a different tax bracket up there, eh?
But it sure is, eh? And I tell you what, it's a way different bracket. And to all you Canadians out there, eh? Give us a call, eh? We're ready to play some fucking football, eh? And knock their fucking socks off, eh? Because we got your fucking back, eh? And when you want some fucking hockey, we'll take care of that too, huh? You know what I mean, eh?
Hey,
we looking out for our... Shout out to all our Canadians, eh? The BC weed you guys got is terrible, but we do love your business and we love making you a lot of money. And one thing I do love about you guys, besides Drake, who makes me sick sitting front row at the games and shit, is you guys do support your team. They fill up the arena. They support, and for that, I love you. I wish our Americans did the same thing.
The Rogers Center up there in Toronto, Steve.
That's a fucking fact. Dodgers. The Los Angeles Dodgers in first... Excuse me. They host San Francisco, okay? They're not in first place.
They are, actually.
But they're not.
They just passed
San
Fran.
They're not in first place with Baltimore. I was reading what we just went over before. Mm-hmm. Toronto's in first place. This division. Dodgers are in first place, but they host San Francisco, followed by the Cubs next week. Now, that's speaking of first place to tie the two together.
The Dodgers have gotten hot.
Yeah.
Their lineup is...
It's phenomenal.
It's crazy. They just added J.J. Redick to the lineup, as we know.
I honestly...
At the trade deadline. They're on fire. I mean, they're beating the shit out of Philly right now, presently as we speak. I mean, my man Chase Utley came into Philly and hit a grand slam the other day. Unbelievable. Dodgers have won 7 out of their last 10. They passed the Giants just as I predicted. They're a game and a half up on the Giants right now.
Last podcast, they were a game down. Now they're a game and a half just within, 7 days?
But like you said, they got some big games coming up. They're going to be hosting San Fran.
Oh.
And then they got to play the Cubs. So their schedule's going to get a little tougher than the Phillies.
You think so? It's going to be a big fucking test. It's one thing you beat up on the Phillies, but you don't overlook Phillies. I told you before, they're a scrappy team. You don't bet with them. You don't bet against them. Plain and fucking simple. However... Dodgers have earned their first place team. As Skip, if there was only a lineup that I would have to second guess that's stronger than the Cubbies, I'd have to say the Dodgers.
I think the Dodgers are going to be dangerous. I said this in the last podcast. A matter of fact, I know they're going to be dangerous. That lineup is sick. If they can get Kershaw...
I don't see him getting hurt.
If they can get Kershaw back in there on the mound, they're going to be real dangerous. I mean, be careful, guys.
Hostins?
I mean, the Cubs are on fire. I mean, what they won 11 straight. They lost one or two games, and now they're back to winning four. I think they're 15-2 now, their last 17. The Cubs are just phenomenal. Best record in baseball. That's going to be one hell of a series, the Cubs and the Dodgers coming up next week.
Let me ask you a question moving on about Cleveland, because we get a lot of comments on Cleveland. Does Cleveland have a legitimate chance of making a World Series appearance?
No.
No. My answer would be, it would be pretty cool to see Cubs or Indians win it all. I'd have to say they don't have a fucking chance because Indians is one of those teams that used to have a lot of tradition. Me and you have said this a lot. Even all the movies were made with Cleveland. Remember the Charlie Sheen movies where they were Cleveland and shit? They had a tradition like New York Yankees, Dodgers. And it's like all these top teams are just falling off. San Francisco 49ers, just to break up another like major sport. It's these newer teams that are coming over and taking over. But to talk about Cleveland winning it, I think they'd choke at the end. They have a strong enough team to get there. They could scrap their way to the World Series. Do I see them getting there and winning? Now I see them making it far, doing something to fuck up and not making the World Series.
I think the team that's going to represent the American League in the World Series is going to come out of the East. I mean, you got Toronto or Boston most likely. I don't think Baltimore's got what it takes. I truly believe it's going to be Toronto, in my opinion.
I'd like it to be the Cubs. I mean, Cleveland just got a championship in basketball. Could you imagine if they got one in baseball?
Yeah, it'd be crazy for the city of Cleveland. I mean, they've been waiting for this long, and then LeBron gets them a championship, and then Francona and the Cleveland Indians get one. I don't know. I just don't see it happening.
Did you? But yeah, I know. And you know what? We didn't see Cleveland fucking Cavaliers winning the motherfucking championship either, did we?
No, we didn't.
We didn't plan on... Steph Kerr's wife saying that it was embarrassing to watch your husband go out there and throw the game either, did we? We heard a lot of foul shit in them NBA playoffs, didn't we? But anyway, it would be cool if Cleveland won and Cleveland won. But to all you Cleveland people, sorry, Brandon. I just don't see it happening.
Well, just to sum up some of the baseball, I'll talk about a couple other teams that are hot. Kansas City's won 8 out of 10. They won 4 in a row, but they're not going anywhere. The Texas Rangers playing real good baseball, Steve. They're up 5.5 games on Seattle. They're up 10 games on Houston. Houston's been falling apart here this week. They lost 4 in a row. The Astros don't have what it takes. They just don't have the heart. I mean, that lineup just isn't hitting this year. I don't know what's wrong with them, but without Altuve, man, I mean, they're pathetic.
It's embarrassing.
But the Texas Rangers, winners of 3 straight, up 5.5 games in the division there on Seattle and 10 on Houston. They're playing real good ball. The Cubs are phenomenal. Dodgers are hot, and Toronto's taking over first place.
Yeah, you said Toronto, out of all the teams in Major League. It's coming out your mouth a lot. Are you fucking go Canada now or what?
Oh, Canada.
Oh, fuck, eh?
You want to talk about a couple teams that aren't hot? How about the LA Angels? When are they going to fire Mike Socha? I've been calling for him to get fired for the last 5 years.
A complete disgrace.
Mike Socha, you are just an absolute disgrace. Geez, I think they've lost, what, 12 out of 13 games now? I mean, just absolutely horrible. They've lost 10, 11 in a row. They won one game, and they go right back to losing again last night. Left the bases loaded in the seventh, left the bases loaded in the ninth. It's just pathetic. I mean, Mike Sosa, you've got to go. You've got to make some changes out there in Anaheim because, man, oh, man, the Angels are pathetic. The Halos, terrible.
But it's set up to have a great team. The arena's nice. The lineup's nice. Get him the fuck out of here.
The payroll's nice.
Payroll's, yeah, nice and high. It's the fucking, they got Yankee problems over there,
buddy.
They're
spending a lot of money over there in Anaheim and not getting any results. Detroit Tigers, I thought they were surging. I got them passing Cleveland. Speaking of Cleveland, I got the Tigers passing Cleveland in the American League Central. However, they're playing terrible. They're 5.5 games back from the Indians. They've only won 3 out of our last 10 games. Detroit slipping a little bit over there too, Steve.
Well, you're speaking terrible. Let's talk about the Mets, the M&M. How about Mets and Milwaukee? You want to talk about some terrible fucking teams.
Milwaukee's lost 4 in a row. The Braves have lost 4 in a row.
Braves.
Horrible.
Yeah. And you know what? The Braves, the type of team to lose 4 in a row and then have a matchup with the Cubs minus $5 and win. You got to watch out for Atlanta. They're scrappy like Philly. They're fucked up, but just absolutely teams that are disappointing. Then they make a little run and beat some good guys. You start watching them again, but teams definitely not to bet. Follow in between the lines, guys. It doesn't take a rocket scientist to figure out. Stay the fuck away from them. San Diego Padres, weird.
Oh, horrible.
Minnesota fucking Twins.
San Diego Padres, they got a Triple-A team on the field right now, Steve.
It's embarrassing.
They're just absolutely horrible.
California, let's just round it out with Oakland sucking a good old-fashioned cock, too.
Oh, Oakland's pathetic, too.
This California, take the L.A. Dodgers out of it, is fucked. Dodgers is strictly holding the state of California on their back when California should be deeper than Kim and Khloe Kardashian's pussy hole.
Canal.
And you know how fucking deep that is.
Well, the Giants are hanging in there. I mean, they've lost 4 in a row. They're not going to win the division. The Dodgers are going to beat them, and I wouldn't be surprised if the Giants don't even make the postseason. You heard it right here.
Right. And just to sum up baseball, ladies and gentlemen, if you haven't gotten involved with our baseball, go to fucking VIPSportsLasVegas.com. We're kicking ass in baseball. Even if you like football, guys, I don't want you to be racist. Please don't be a racist. We don't like racism here. Do not be prejudiced to the size, shape, or color of the ball. I understand you like football, and a lot of you say I don't like baseball. As long as it makes you money, I don't care if it's a pissing contest or a cockroach race. As long as I got the information and it pays, that's all that matters. Don't go into this football season using your own money. Use the bookie's money. Go to VIP Sports Las Vegas. Let's make some money betting baseball. We're on fire right now. Like I said, my nickname in the Screech. It's in the Screech. You think my cush is good?
Your nickname is Screech? Remember that guy, Screech?
Oh, my God. Yeah. My nickname in the streets is El Scorcho Steve.
Yes.
A.K.A. Steve Steveroni.
The Bookie Killer, El Scorcho.
Yeah, El Scorcho Killer. Moving on. Anything else in baseball?
No, just a couple of series to look out for this weekend if you're paying attention. Speaking of the Boston Red Sox and the Detroit Tigers, they'll be playing each other up in the Motor City this weekend. Red Sox at Detroit. That's going to be a big series for Detroit. They need to come out of there with a couple of wins. Speaking of the Canadians, the Toronto Blue Jays are in Cleveland. Speaking of Cleveland and the Blue Jays, they play each other this weekend, Steve.
Do they?
Cleveland Indians. Yeah, Toronto Blue Jays come across the border to play Cleveland this weekend. New York Mets are out in the Bay playing San Francisco. That should be a half-decent series. And the other one I'd watch is that Houston team that I said just don't have it. They've lost 4 in a row. They have to go into Baltimore, play Baltimore this weekend, who has the first or the second best record at home.
At home, right.
Yeah, in all of baseball. So
I thought they were in first place. Who is in first place with the best home record?
Dodgers? Dodgers are pretty good. No, Cubs probably. Cubs,
it has to be.
Cubs and Baltimore.
It has to be.
Cubs and Baltimore.
So
Baltimore, very, very good at home. They host the Houston Astros this weekend. Over there in Baltimore.
And teams that, if you're a sports bettor, that you say, fuck you two, are Philly, San Diego, Minnesota,
real bad.
Mets, Atlanta Braves. Watch out and read between the lines, ladies
Angels,
and gentlemen.
Angels.
And there's plenty of other games out there. Look for marquee matchups and look for our phone number and give us a call. Fair enough?
Give us a call, 877-220-6540. Let's make some money together.
Absolutely. Things to say fuck you to on that subject, Tim Tebow. We talked about last week. We're tired of hearing about him. I don't hear nothing about it now. But I guess the word's going around, you know, WWE star The Miz. Do you know who The Miz is?
No idea.
Well, he used to be on MTV's The Real World. He was a little fucking guy running around this, that, and the other. He's actually made a good career for himself. He's now in WWE. But on MTV's Real World, you got to see him actually get on the Real World, try out for it, and turn into it. I tip my hat off to him.
The Miz.
He worked his ass off, used the Real World as a stepping stone mm-hmm. to become a WWE. And if you don't think that Kush is good,
man, what do you want? What do you want? Cherry double backflip cherry pie? Or?
Can I be the God's honest truth?
Mm-hmm.
Nothing.
Oh, that's the
that's
problem. That's the problem.
Couple problems at home. Little home problems going on. Not smoking really right now. So, you know, if I blew, I'd just be going over it. But excited that he made himself into a WWE star. You deserve it. He makes money. But anyway, The Miz says Tebow should join the WWE if porn doesn't work out, like I said. Do you think he could be a WWE star?
No.
I think he could. Well, he maybe a diva. You know, they have the bitches version of the wrestlers. He could definitely not be a WWE men.
He could be a
he could be an assistant to one of the divas.
So he could carry around the, like a ring girl.
Like
carry,
one of the bitches or yeah, something.
Carry around.
Put a G-string on and go in there and walk around. But so, I mean, once again, everybody wants him to succeed. But out of everything out there, I think I came up with the only answer and the only chance he has at making millions of dollars. I say gay porn. If you can find, ladies and gentlemen, if you can find me one thing that Tim Tebow can make more money than gay porn, I want you to make your comment and tell me right now. I say gay porn is the only thing Tim Tebow can make money at. You tell me what fucking any type of professional thing he can do to make more money at. What occupation?
I think you hit the nail on the head.
Oh, I know I did. And he's willing to take the nail on the head as well.
Oh, boy.
Anyway, let me ask you this quick question. Derrick Rose still thinks he has a superstar team in New York. How many mollies and how many joints is this motherfucker smoking today?
Wow.
I mean, Rose, you robbed the Bulls. You had a great team going. You hurt yourself. You fucked their team over. You took all the fucking energy they had. Now you're in New York. We've never seen you with any women. I've never seen you fuck anybody. You got all the money. You're a superstar. I don't see you in the headlines fucking anybody. Are you gay? And, you know, I'm not trying to call you out, buddy, but fuck some women, would you? You're the only NBA player that has ankle problems and not back problems. Most supposed to be lower back if you're getting a lot of pussy, not knees, homie. But anyway, the answer is absolutely not. You guys do not have a superstar team out in New York. You're a 500 team at best. Yeah, what do you have to say about that?
They're definitely not a super team. Let's just I'll just stop right there.
I just don't think the kid's very smart. I think he got a lot of money for basketball, didn't pay that much. The only person I see robbing the league more than him was probably Jason Williams, who later on shot his butler with a fucking shotgun in his fucking limo in his house, in his ranch.
Wow.
A guy that just made $90 million from the league and just didn't play anymore. You know
lost,
what I mean?
Lost his mind, huh?
Yeah, that's a fact. That's pretty much it. Moving on, I also wanted to mention when we were talking about baseball, not to go backwards, but this is very impressive because this guy is a pimp. Bryce Harper hits a 481-foot home run, his longest home run ever. If you were starting a team, would he be basically
your
first pick, yes or no?
He'd definitely be in the top three.
Well, who would be your first pick?
Well,
Would you have to get Arrieta?
No, I wouldn't get Arrieta. I'd probably go
How
for...
How the fuck would you say
I'd have to? I'd have to get Kershaw. I mean, I'd have to go...
Okay.
Got to go for a superstar pitcher.
Correct.
But,
all-around superstar, huh?
Yeah,
not just who's hot right now. Yeah, well...
Bryce Harper, Chris Bryant, a couple of Vegas boys. I mean, they...
So basically, a pitcher and a couple of Vegas boys is what you're saying, Skip?
Oh, yeah. Uh-huh.
I mean, that's the truth, right?
Pretty much, yeah.
You'd have to go get you a fucking pitcher and a couple of Vegas boys if you're going to start your team.
Yeah, I'd be looking for Nolan Arenado from the Rockies. He's a fucking absolute beast. I'd be looking for, Bryce Harper. I'd be looking for Chris Bryant and a couple of superstar pitchers like Kershaw.
I'd like to give out a shout-out to my city where I'm born and raised, Las Vegas, Nevada. Shout-out to the east, north, west, every side that you could possibly think of Las Vegas. Thank you for all the programs that we got to get our kids to college. We're producing some of the best baseball players in the major leagues right now. Thanks to Fertitas and Gorman and UNLV, our football program is going to be big. Hopefully we can work something out with the Raiders where UNLV gets with them. And as far as UNLV basketball, as us being number one and as we know it, I'd like to tell our athletic director from the bottom of my heart to suck my fucking dick. You've ruined UNLV basketball. Oh, you've ruined our tradition. Skip, don't act like you didn't like they used to have fun eating a fucking couple dogs sitting behind the bench with the arena packed rooting in a decent team.
Yeah.
It's a little disappointing for a guy that was born and raised that way, who was in the arena with Tarkanian when we won the championship. That's the only thing I had growing up as a kid.
They've gone to hell, man.
So thank you, the athletic department, for ruining our fucking basketball program. Fuck you. But yes, UNLV football is our future. And thank you for all the people out there helping our kids get better. Makes me feel good about having my son growing up here as a baseball player. It lets you know right off the bat, he could easily make the major leagues, right, Skip?
There's definitely a lot of scouts in this city, I'll say that.
So anyway, shout out to Bryce Harper for just constantly impressing motherfuckers. 481 foot, pound for pound. It's pretty fucking serious.
That's a bomb.
Yeah. Now, let's get right back into these preseason NFL games that everybody's excited. Everybody's at Wild Wings tonight. Everybody's drinking beer, eating hot dogs. But what are we worried about doing tonight when we see football on TV?
We're worried about covering the damn spread.
Now, do you give a fuck about a free t-shirt or a hot dog?
No, I do not.
Keep your free coffee, keep your fucking free beer, and keep your free coffee mug, because I'm coming in your book to break your fucking neck.
Keep your 75-cent hot dogs.
So you can take your hot dog and shove it right up your ass. That's what you do with it, all right? You guys out there looking for a free hot dog and a $5 parlay, you are labeled a degenerate. You may have a problem with sports betting, okay? Guys out there that want to treat it like a business, that want to make money, that is successful, or want to be more successful at what they do, give us a call. Let's get you paid.
We're in the second week of the NFL preseason.
Preach it.
Tonight, Thursday night, starts the NFL preseason week two. This is where the teams play a little more serious, the second and third weeks. We all know the fourth week, they pretty much take off. If you're not betting the NFL preseason and you're waiting for the regular season, shame on you.
Skip.
Shame on you. We already popped a couple of winners in week one of the preseason.
Skip.
We're looking to pop a couple more winners this weekend. The lines are very, very soft right now, Steve.
They're softer than Charlie Sheen's cock on Coke. And it doesn't get any softer than that, my friend. The lines on these preseason games are softer than Charlie Sheen's cocaine cock.
Oh, my God.
Okay?
That's pretty soft, I suppose.
That's soft as it possibly gets. ladies and gentlemen, I don't know what's softer. Lamb Skip?
Oh, my God.
We're going to get off Charlie Sheen's cold cock. Go ahead and continue.
All right, well.
They're soft. The lines are soft.
Yeah. The odds, the lines on preseason NFL, Steve, are usually between, minus 2.5 up to maybe 4. Occasionally, you're going to see a 6. Because the odds makers are using last year's power ratings pretty much just to set the lines on the games during preseason. You'll notice a lot of time the home team is just minus 3 because they don't know what else to do.
They're going off power ratings from the year before, right, which has nothing to fucking do with what's going on here.
The practice squads are open to the public right now. The information is a lot easier to attain, especially when you got the money and the contacts behind you, like Steve does. The coaches are going as far as scripting the first 25 or 30 plays of offense they're going to run. You know exactly who's playing, how long they're going to play. You know whether they're going to work on the running game or the passing game. Some coaches like to win in preseason. Some coaches don't give a damn about preseason. There's a lot of variables that go into the NFL preseason.
Some are working on offense. Some are working on defense. Yes, some are working on special teams. Some are working on two-point conversions.
This time of the year, they tell you more than they're ever going to tell you what they're going to do in the game. So believe me, there's a major advantage. Give us a call, and we'll help you this weekend with some preseason NFL. And we'll also help you kick your guys' ass when it comes to baseball, because we're on fire in baseball.
Can I tell you one thing that I don't ever want to see, and I think you might agree with me?
What's that?
I don't ever want to see any team out there practicing a two-point conversion. You know why?
Why?
Because it's hard enough for these sorry-ass fucking kickers to make extra points and fucking field goals. They should get every fucking attempt possible. Yeah. If anybody needs any work in the NFL, it's these motherfucking kickers conquering their game. Because they fuck up spreads and games every single year, every fucking day. And now that they've moved it back a little bit,
understand. A lot more extra points are being missed.
And in preseason, they're not letting the guy take the 55-yard field goal. Give your field goal kicker every opportunity in the world to make it. Because you're going to need him a hell of a lot more than that fucking two-point attempt when you're trying to do something.
I agree.
All right, so to you teams out there, you better have your kickers out there every fucking opportunity that you possibly have. Because they can't get enough training, Skip.
Yeah, we definitely don't want to be hitting the upright in the fourth quarter with 30 seconds left.
And like I said, baseball is in full effect. Football is here. So there's no more excuse. Call your bookie. Guys, if your bookie doesn't open for another 3 weeks, get an offshore account, put $500 in it, and let us make you $5,000 before your bookie opens in 3 weeks.
Yeah.
Is that so hard to do?
Makes perfect sense to me.
I don't want to hear about, oh, my bookie's not open yet. Well, get an offshore account, spend $500, and let us flip it like a world-class fucking women's gymnast.
Well, I'll tell you this. Just because your bookie isn't taking bets right now
doesn't mean you can't make money.
Yeah, don't let your bookie dictate to you what you're going to do.
You hit it right on the head.
I mean, come on, man.
Jesus.
Just because you got one little local pissant book that doesn't open up for another 2 or 3 weeks.
Fuck him.
Don't let him tie your hands. Don't let him dictate your bankroll.
Mm-mm.
Shame on you.
That is correct. And speaking of a different football, English Premier Soccer League is in full effect. Skip, we got to give a round of applause. First of all, ladies and gentlemen, and I do say ladies, I'd like to thank and congratulate everybody that called and signed up for soccer packages from VIP Sports. 65 orders in the last 10 days on English Premier Soccer signups, brother.
Absolutely.
Congratulations, everybody out there signed up. And if you haven't signed up out there, you need to. Go to VIP Sports Las Vegas, 877-220-6540. We cover all major European leagues. We have packages available for all size, shape, and colors. Now, the main thing that I want to address, what separates VIP from everybody else, Skip, we're not just the biggest company in the United States. We're the only company that's worldwide.
We're absolutely worldwide.
Let's talk about that a little bit right now. And I want to give a shout out to all my competitors who are dialing 15-time burn leads, who are out there trying to get a room together, text blasting people on 5-year-old leads, because nobody's advertising, there's no one out there to call. Why don't you go ahead and tell them, Skip? Well, I mean, I'm
talking to people from countries I never even heard of, and I'm pretty educated.
We're the only company that it's worldwide. Norway.
I got
the Netherlands. Africa.
It's unbelievable.
Germany.
Yeah.
Ireland. Countries I've never even heard before or even knew existed.
Right now, I got clients from Malaysia, from Australia, from the UK, from Germany, Switzerland, and Estonia. Wherever the fuck that is. Estonia. New Zealand. Man, the New Zealand guys are coming out of the woodwork.
I don't know what we're doing in Australia. Listen, money talks is running
around.
See, and I want to let you guys know out there what's going on here, and it's what made us worldwide. CNBC in the United States has a bankroll to fund shows and do their thing. CNBC in every other country is completely broke. They don't have $10,000 to record any show, so they only record what they like in the scraps of what CNBC has rights to. Mm-hmm. Our show is like the biggest show out of the country right now ever. They run it non-fucking stop. New Zealand and Australia, we're getting more calls than I've ever got, ever.
Right.
We've got 25 internet orders all from out of the country. Yeah. Where the fuck are our U.S. people?
Yeah.
We had 7 U.S. internet orders last week, 31 from out of the country.
I got to tell you, I literally have over 20 clients that I'm personally dealing with that are outside of the U.S. that just came in from all the airings of Money Talks all around the world. It's insane.
You've worked for the biggest in the world.
It's insane.
You worked for Grandpa Feist before he got into diapers and wanted to get back in the business. You worked for all these other guys. And have you ever had a company that was worldwide like us?
No.
Okay.
No.
So you'd say that we've tapped into something that no one can even take. We tapped into a keg that no one even knows where the keg's at.
We've taken over the world, the globe.
Correct. And that's pretty much what it is. So shout out to everybody around the world. This is what I'm getting at. Thank you for your support. To shout out to every country. Next podcast, we'll go over our list of people that signed up because we're missing at least 10 fucking countries that I don't even know how to pronounce or say. Portugal, Brazil, Rio. Because of the Olympics, we're getting a lot of people calling as well. The Netherlands.
It's insane.
So Welcome aboard, ladies and gentlemen.
Talking to people from all over the world every day, Steve.
Back to the soccer.
One phone call, I might be talking to Hawaii. The next phone call, I'm talking to Estonia.
Yeah.
The next phone call, I'm talking to Australia. The next phone call, I'm talking to Topeka, Kansas.
Yeah. So when you get worldwide, let us know, ladies and gentlemen. I'd have to go out on a limb and say, my company makes more money from out of the country than all the sports services in Las Vegas combined.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, that's pretty much a real stat.
That's probably a fair statement.
Shout out to the fat boy and the other fat boy over there calling some old burned out leads trying to text blast. Barb's still sucking cock. Just back to soccer. Leicester City loses first game as defending premier champ, Skipper. Leicester City opened up its campaign as champions with a trip to Hull City. To say that the champs looked ugly isn't even the half of it. They came out and looked like they came right from Shitsville. I don't know if these guys party, they do party. They get out of the country, they fuck fine women, and they do their thing. Hull, who only had 13 first-team players, listen to what the fuck I say here. Hull, who only had 13 first-team players available, defeated them 2-1.
Crazy.
Didn't even have a starting team. Only had 13 eligible players.
The defending champions.
And they beat the defending champions, yeah. Guys, get off the champagne. Get off the ecstasy. Get off the molly. Get off your bitch and get back to your profession. And that's playing fucking football / soccer.
Their own coach said there's a better chance of E.T. returning down to Earth than them winning the championship.
Yeah, you would have had a better chance of E.T. coming down on homeboy's bike in a basket and picking the team up than them fucking losing. And sure enough, they lose. So it looks like phone home, motherfucker. You better watch your mouth because E.T. came. You lost.
Yeah, the coach said there's no way they're going to repeat. That's for sure.
No.
It's nice to know your coach has faith in you, though.
Yeah. Manchester City star goalie Joe Hart gets benched. So, I mean, these coaches out here are playing hard. The fans were shocked when star goalie Joe Hart was left on the bench for the opening game.
Crazy.
You're the superstar, Skip. You get benched. People are coming to see you. I don't think people got, you know, the coaches have to remember that. Hart, who is the goalie for the England national team, he's been with Manchester City for over 8 years.
Mm-hmm.
New manager Pep said that he doesn't play just a certain 11 guys and that he just decided to go with a backup goalie, Wilfredo. Hey, I don't just play the same guys. I don't like to win a lot. I put in Wilfredo. Forget about it. So you put in fucking Fettuccine Alfredo, a backup goalie, when you got a champion superstar sitting on the bench. Does this spell the beginning or the end for Joe Hart at Manchester City? If I'm the goalie, I want the fuck out of there. You have a personal problem that no one knows about. Yeah, I'd have to say there's a problem there.
Something's going on.
Yeah, something's going on there big time. Also breaking news, which I've told everybody several times, if we get anything out of the Olympics, and people have been saying this nonstop, it's not to talk about Ryan Lochte. He had the last Olympics. He got a show on E. He showed the world who he was, which was a dork, nerd, weirdo fucking guy that no one in the world wanted to follow.
You called this guy out on the last podcast, and now look what happened.
I already said that. I mean, the only thing we want to get out of these Olympics is Michael Phelps and not to hear nothing about Ryan Lochte because he's the only guy that starts shit up. So,
and look what happened.
Yeah, news broke. The video has surfaced on 4 U.S. swimmers. And by the way, I gotta tell you a story this morning, Skip. I was up early watching my son. You know, in the morning you got Dan Patrick, which I love, by the way, in the Rich Eisen show. Rich Eisen has a guest doing a show as if I had like somebody else completely do it. Mm-hmm. Someone from the room, okay?
Right.
This brother, I forget what his name is. But he's doing the story all day today. I'm watching him this morning. He's calling Ryan Lochte Ron Lockett throughout the whole story that I'm about to go over right now. This is today. If you guys think I'm bullshitting,
Ron Lockett?
Pull up the Rich Eisen show and watch the dude call him Ron the whole time. This guy doesn't even have a clue who the fuck he is. And Rich Eisen, if you're going to get a guy to host your show, go over the stuff with the guy. Let him know who he's talking about. The guy's a swimmer. The Olympics, remember last year? Mm-hmm. Last Olympics, he had a show on E! Don't allow a guy to come and just read a fucking script.
Yeah.
Because it doesn't mean anything, and your viewers just don't like it, bro. And by the way, he made himself look like a fucking idiot. Because it made him sound like he just didn't know what he was talking about. So what I want to ask you guys out there, okay? And like I said, who do you like better? Rich Eisen or the Steve Stevens VIP Sports Podcast? Bottom fucking line. Would you rather see me on ESPN doing Rich Eisen's show or would you rather see him? You put your comments in. Like I said, we give it to you raw. I'm actually dealing with players, coaches, CEOs. The reason why I can't have current NFL coaches, players, scouts and all these people on my show is because I'm tied into sports betting.
Right.
And for me to give up my sports betting business, which people have offered me multi-millions of dollars to go do shows where I would be as big as Dan Patrick, my idol, the guy that I love that makes me laugh. Rich Eisen, great guy, but I can give you a show. Me and you can kill them, Skip. I'm not talking about Dan. Dan's got his show down, but any other sports guy out there, me and you can eat him up alive, entertain people more. However, we're not allowed to bring all these current coaches
right.
and political people onto our show because we're so deeply tied into Las Vegas and sports betting.
Yeah.
So don't think for a second, and Skip, I'm sorry, and I don't even think you're mad at me because you make seven figures at your sports job, but you got to admit, the offers that we've had, you went home a lot of times and threw your head against the wall. It's kind of a hard decision. Do we give up sports everything?
Do we give up sports
betting to go make millions of dollars to do a square TV show?
We walk a fine line. It's very, very hard to get athletes or coaches in here.
We can't.
Just simply because we're tied to sports betting and they do not want their faces seen.
They can't. They'll get fired.
Yeah,
I can't bring the commissioner of the NBA on here, but he can call Dan Patrick. You understand that?
Right.
What I'm trying to say, guys, would you rather see me give it to you raw and actually hang out with all these players and give you the real on my podcast and blow this up organically and have retired players on here? Or would you rather me square up, go make $5 million a year, take Rich Eisen's job, and go give it to you on ESPN and have nothing to do with sports betting?
Mm-hmm.
Sorry, I can't give it to you the other way. I make millions and millions of dollars betting sports, and I always will. Just trying to find a happy medium to give them both to you. That's all I'm trying to do, guys. And we've been doing that for a long time. Story I asked to get off. Sorry, I went off a little thing about Rich Eisen, but don't have a guy host your show that doesn't even know what the fuck he's talking about. So anyway, Ryan Lochte was in a... Here's the bottom line. Four U.S. swimmers, including Ryan Lochte, involved in an altercation at a gas station in Brazil. It appears the story about... they said they were held at gunpoint with a gun by people they thought were Brazilian police
mm-hmm.
and were robbed for their wallets and all their money. So they're coming up with a story that they were just having a good time on their way home, pulled over by Brazilian police, put a gun to their head and robbed their money. Now you want the real story from Steve Stevens? They're out drunk as fuck. The dude Ryan Lochte is already a fucking moron idiot. Everybody knows that. They followed his life on E. He's a fucking idiot. Couldn't even get a second season. Because he was just straight fucking stupid. At the end of the day, says we were robbed at gunpoint. What they were doing is they were pissy drunk.
Mm-hmm.
They were out till 4 in the morning, pulled over to a gas station where the door was locked. They all had to take a piss. The gas station was closed. The door was locked. They kicked in the door at the gas station, pretty much kicked it open,
mm-hmm.
vandalized it, pissed everywhere, vandalized the store. Police were called. Later on, they got pulled over. Got held at gunpoint, and the reason why their wallets and they were detained and got taken was to pay for the damages that they did at the gas station.
Unbelievable.
So, I mean, guys, you're not representing the United States too well. You're fucking idiots. Brazil, even if they were dirty and the police were dirty, they're sure as fuck not going to be during the Olympics.
Right.
Not in the middle of the public eye. You know what I mean? So to come out with a story, act like you got held up at gunpoint, to make our people not want to watch the Olympics or not want to go there. Shame on you for being a dumbass, 4 in the morning, drunk, swimming fucking dork that no one likes anyway. This is the only way your name would make the fucking public. I knew something like this would come up. You make me fucking sick, and you're a dork. I would mention the other swimmers, but I don't think anyone gives a fuck about them.
Well, it's a shame that they got caught up in that because I think it was fucking Ryan Lochte's doings. I think he pretty much is the leader of the pack there, and the other guys got caught up in his bullshit, and he came up with this story about how they got robbed and got pulled over, and I don't know. The whole thing is just crazy. It makes the U.S. look bad. You're a moron, and it's just insane. And somehow he got out of the country.
Yeah, they doubted the story the whole fucking time. He already knew he was lying the whole fucking time. So the couple swimmers were on board a flight to return back to the U.S. on Wednesday. Police, you know, boarded them off the plane, took their passports, had them stay in Brazil. Why Ryan Lochte scooted out of the country right away because he already knew he was lying.
Unbelievable.
Unfucking real, guys. Not a way to represent the U.S. Didn't like Lochte. Never will. Only thing that you need to be locked up is in a fucking insane asylum. Right?
So he got his ass out of the country. Meanwhile, the other guys that he, like, you know, helped, made lie or whatever. I mean, yeah. they're...
He's the leader of the crew. He was drunk, got him out drunk, kicked open the door. He already thinks he's like hard, listening to rap like I do and shit. He thinks he's like hard. He's listening to too many rap music songs, and he's a fucking dork. Out there drunk, leading the pack, vandalized the place, got caught, acted like he got robbed, and just fucking ruined a...
Meanwhile, he gets out of the country, and the other three guys are held up back in Brazil.
And once again, making us look stupid.
And making
Moving
the,
on.
Yeah, making the U.S. look like not good.
Yeah, I told you I didn't like the guy, and for that exact reason.
Unbelievable.
Johnny Depp waves the white flag finally with his wife, Amber, in a divorce. Johnny Depp saw the writing on the wall and decided to settle. She gets $7 million. They were only married 1 year.
Nice.
I mean, that is a lot of fucking money, dude.
Yeah.
You know, I don't give a fuck how verbally abusive he was or whatever the case was. I'm sure she did some stuff to get Johnny a little upset. You know what I mean?
Apparently it was a violent situation there.
Well, here it is. He was accused of domestic violence, as everybody knows. And last weekend, her team gave a video of Johnny going into a fucking rage of anger.
Mm-hmm.
The video was heavily edited, but showed Johnny breaking a wine glass, a bottle of wine, slamming glass cabinets, just going absolutely fucking crazy. Apparently, Johnny and his team and his lawyers saw that things were only going to get dirtier and decided to settle with Amber.
Mm-hmm.
It is reported that Amber got $7 million for property damage. Basically... just like women that are out to get guys with money, setting him up, videotape the guy, going crazy. The bitch probably drew him to go crazy to start with. Then she starts filming $7 million later. If he's settling for $7 million, she probably has a video of fucking him in the butthole and about 11 other different things that he doesn't want to come out. He knows that she's starting to play dirty. Take this $7 million and get the fuck out of here, bitch.
Goodbye.
Because that's nothing for Johnny Depp.
Wow.
But for men out there that have to sacrifice a girl driving them insane and then having to pay, man, just leave the relationship early. It's not really worth it.
You probably got off cheap, $7
million. For his bankroll, yeah. Absolutely. Moving on. In hip-hop news, The Game. Love The Game. Always loved everything about him. Claimed to have sex with three Kardashians. Game said, he came out and said that I fucked three Kardashians. We already know that he used to date Kim Kardashian back in 2007. Mm. We know she fucks everyone that she goes out with, so we can assume that she was pussy hole number one, okay? So write it down. Kim was the Kardashian number one that The Game fucked in 2007. We could assume number two would be Khloe. Khloe fucks anybody that buys her a shot at tequila. Okay, so we already know, and a couple years ago, Khloe was spotted hanging out with The Game, and I would have to assume that Khloe would be the number two Kardashian pussy he fucked.
Okay, reasonable assumption.
Kim number one, Khloe number two. The big question is, who the fuck is number three? It only leaves Kylie and...
Kendall.
And Kendall.
And Courtney.
And Courtney, at least three sisters left, okay? Courtney has bad breath, really likes white boys. I can't see The Game fucking her no matter how drunk she is. I've seen her attitude in the past. Courtney has a thing for white cock, and she goes out and gets it. Kendall's not really racist. Kendall will probably take a dick or two down. She might want to be behind closed doors. She's handling her business pretty professional. I like that about her. Now, Kylie, I'd have to say the arrow points right at you. I look in your eye, and you have a fetish for black cock like no other girl I've ever seen in my life, which doesn't make you a bad person. Just means you don't like the average 6-inch white cock. You want a 15-inch cock? You want to drop a tear? I understand. It doesn't make you a bad girl at all. So, assuming from me, Steve Stevens, I'd have to say, number three, Kylie got The Game's cock in her mouth and buzz.
Oh.
So now here's the deal. Here's the thing. The Kardashians put a statement out that says this is completely untrue. Is The Game telling the truth? And what sister is number three? So this is what I want the people out there to answer for me. Do you think The Game is telling the truth? Skipper, I'm going to start with you.
Yes, I do.
I say not yes, but fuck yes, he is. I want you guys out there to ask, the first question is The Game telling the truth? Did he fuck all three Kardashians? And the second question is, Skip, we can assume Kim and Khloe were number one and two. Who was number three, Kendall or Kylie or Courtney?
I'm going to have to go with your theory.
Kylie?
I think Courtney is sticking to the white penis. And
she has a pattern. I'm just going back to
yeah,
a pattern.
Yeah, and me too. I mean, I don't really know, but well, I'm going to go ahead and go with your theory.
My theory?
Yeah.
And like I said, black, white, we're, this world is all mixed, so there's no prejudice of what color you are or what size, shape, and show, you know, the ball is the bet. Everybody's everybody. Everybody. We just got men and women. Like I said, I've never been prejudiced, never have, never will be, but I know what women like. Just like I've always known my whole life, those certain Asian women don't like me. And I don't like them. You ever had that certain, well, you've had your girlfriend from the beginning, but guys know like that certain girl that you don't like and they don't like me. I don't know what it is. Like all my boys, they've always had these certain type and I never liked them. But mm-hmm. I'd have to say number three is Kylie. You're saying the same thing?
I'm going to go with your theory, yeah.
Yes or no, is game telling the truth? And who's the third Kardashian they fucked? Mm. And sorry to leave you with the Kardashians as the ending of our show.
That's
but
today's trivia.
That's trivia. That's who got fucked. That's who didn't get fucked. That's who's hot in baseball, and that's who's not. But ladies and gentlemen, like I said, football is here in full effect. I want you guys to take full advantage of it because I know that we are. I'm constantly giving out my Steve Stevens Motivation 101 on Twitter once a week. Sales tips to make you guys better people, make you more positive, to help you when you're down, and just make you a better all salesman all around. You guys want a little advice on what you need to do to get better? Read books. Read motivational books. Read The Closer, Volume 1. Volume 2 and 3 are shit. It's crazy because as a child, as a teenager, I read The Closer, and I actually took everything out of the book and took it to heart. The funny thing is, I actually met the guy, Ben Gay, who wrote the book, and I'll sell circles around the motherfucker. Mm-hmm. Here it is, a guy that wrote the book and couldn't sell a deal to save his life, but he can explain it in a book. However, I read that book, turned it into real life, and helped me create one of the best salesmen in the world. So motivate yourself by reading sales books like The Closer and motivational books like OG Mandino, The Greatest Salesman Alive. It tells you to look in the mirror and tells you you're the best. Don't get frustrated. How much work you have to put in. What you get out. You only get out of things what you put into things. If you give something 100%, you'll get 100% out. If you have a 6-hour shift, you work 3 hours a day, and an hour of it is doing your job, and you still make 10 grand a week, you probably have a job you can make $50,000 a week at if you gave it 100%. You know what I mean? So give it all you got.
You weren't talking about me there, were you?
If the shoe wear fits it. But no, I wasn't even thinking about it.
If the shoe fits wear?
Yeah, I don't know. It don't fit you, though, does it?
No, it don't fit my...
No, fuck
don't,
no.
Don't fit my big ass.
Because you make more than $10,000 anyway. I would have said a guy that's... You know, if I had to use you as that statement, guy that pounds out 5 hours a day, gives it all he's got on the phone for 2 hours, 20 grand a week, could probably make 60. Mm. At the end of the day, nah, buddy. You're my number one gun. We run everything together. It's you and I against the bookie, not you and I against each other.
That's it.
You get the front, I got the back. We'll go to war for each other.
You know it.
But read motivational books and closing books. How to treat your client, whatever business you're in. If he's saying he's not interested, if he's skeptical, if he's been burned, if it's the money, learn how to say it. Learn how to overcome their objections. Learn how to bring laughter into it. Learn how to make a guy laugh. Learn how to bond with a client, but more importantly, learn how to be motivated. And that's all I want to give you guys, the bottom fucking line. Baseball is in full effect. I'm El Scorcho on the streets. Football is officially here. It's on the TV all night tonight. Some of you are watching the podcast while you're scratching your nuts watching football right now. Mm-hmm. And I'm just glad to be able to bring it to you. But guys, don't wait before it's too late. The money's here. It's a $1 trillion industry. You deserve your fair share. Right, Skip?
You better believe it.
Anything you'd like to say to these people?
I just want to say this. It's week two of the NFL preseason. There's a lot of money to be made in the NFL preseason for numerous reasons, some of which I mentioned here today. There's baseball going on every day. We've been kicking the shit out of baseball all summer. It's not going to stop. We still got 2 solid months of baseball left. The postseason is right around the corner. Come and get a piece of this money. When was the last time you went into the regular football season, which is right around the corner in 2 weeks, September 1st, college football is in full swing. When's the last time you went into the regular football season with an extra $10,000 or $20,000 in bankroll? Give us a call, 877-220-6540. Let me help you make money. Let me help you.
And like I said, when's the last time you paid a credit card with a smile on your face? How about that?
Absolutely.
We're the only investment where you can invest $2,500 and make $7,500. The bottom line is, I can show you better than I can tell you. I can talk till I'm blue in the face. We can run commercials. You can run infomercials, ads. But at the end of the day, I can show you better than I can tell you. Give me 1% of your trust. I'll earn the other 99%. Gambling is this close to being legal. Major League Baseball, Dodgers are carrying the West Coast on their back. Chicago Cubs are holding it down. Tim Tebow has a job in porno. They said he should be a wrestler. I don't know. Bryce Harper is a true pimp. If you're going to start a Las Vegas built team, you're definitely going to start, or if you're going to start a Major League team, you're going to get two Las Vegas boys and a pitcher. Football's in full effect preseason. Soccer football, English Premier Soccer League is in full effect. Come get the money. Entertainment news, Johnny Depp's paying bitches. Quit getting married, Johnny. The game fucked all three Kardashians and said his balls still don't itch. So at the end of the day, like I said, Kardashians love cock. We love making money. I don't know who likes it more, us making money or the Kardashians gobbling cock. But at the end of the day, people want what they want and they fucking deserve it. It's a billion-dollar industry. On the behalf of VIP Sports and myself, you deserve the finer things in life. I want to help them, giving them to you. Stay positive. Stay motivated. You can accomplish anything in this world. Take it from me. I've came from nothing and turned it into something. On the behalf of VIP Sports, my staff, the Big Skipper, we love you. See you. Wouldn't want to be you. And like I said, don't let the players be the only ones to get paid. We love you. I'm out.
If money talks, then I got a lot to say. I'm on the grind trying to make $100,000 a day. We play with big cash and we're blowing money fast. Riding in a plush Benz trunk full of money bags. I need a G for every light bulb on the Vegas strip. Naked bitches in my mansion dancing to some player shit. Made a grip on the grind, but I started out with nothing. Dealt me a bad hand, but I still won bluffing. I'm Steve Stevens. I make G's when I'm sleeping. Some coward shot me up as they ain't want to see me breathing. Nice try, but my bosses never die. Fresh out the hospital, stitched up, getting high. In the game that I pick, believe me, it's a winner. What I know could get you rich, cause all I pick is winners. I ain't perfect, I'm a sinner. All about making wages. We love to gamble out here. Welcome to Las Vegas. Money talks. Money talks. Money talks.